बस बनाने से थोड़ा ह्यूमन एलिमेंट इंटैक्ट रहता है.
इंटरेस्टिंग. हेलो नमस्कार, कैसी हैं आप? हाउ हैव यू बीन शालिनी?
I'm fine, Sambhava. How have you been?
I'm good, and I know we're both in the same city, but unfortunately we cannot be meeting live. But hoping for things to get better, I'll come see you. But you know what special is? Good stories cannot wait. So thank you. We've always said this out loud, that you've been a very, very big support and encouragement to Zykana ever since we conceived this. And we've been waiting to, cover your story from the last year. And things unfolded and it couldn't work out. But here we are now. And because we believe that whether virtually or really, good stories have the power to heal. So here we are. You're looking lovely. And I know. As we progress further in the story, more things will unfold about all the things you lay your magic on. It's your house, or the decor, or the things you create, your love and passion for handicrafts, and just the sheer affection for plants and sustainability. So I would let you talk more about it.
So when the lockdown hit, so I'd started off with first, storing, those essential things and let me, not go out of much. And being an 80s, born, we have seen that era as well of, era with technology. So that's when I thought, okay, let's go back there. And how was our living there? That was the initial idea. And I went back there and started to think from there. I think that initially helped me. One of them is sustainable living and, not having a really cozy life as we call today. That started, preparing recipes which, would take less time. Having your own kitchen garden, where you can just have your basic supplies for your family, and then wanted to control the garbage, that would pile up every day, because there are workers who put their lives to risk, who would come and do this work for you, to help them indirectly or to the environment, I started to do this home compost. Of course, those would they would not go up to a landfill, and I feel really responsible, when I do something to the environment, at the same time do something to my garden or to my family. So that's all, it started as Sambhava.
That's beautiful, and it's very inspiring, because sustainability is one element that's picking up. You see objects as something that can bring transformation, and they don't need to be, and you add that angle of beauty too. If we talk about these little cute experiences like the breezer bottles, which is your first, which is a memory of you and your husband spending quality time together, you have converted that into art in your house, to be reusing the old boxes, and then going about this whole having your own kitchen garden. Yeah. You have some in your own kitchen, and then on the terrace you do all that work. How do you look at those objects which are discarded? Like, what goes in your mind, Shalini, when you're looking at a particular object getting discarded, and what does that creative process look like?
Not everything that gets in your house has to go out at some point in time, right? It can live along with you. So that's the first thought. Next, I'm not a person who would want to spend a lot of money in decorating my house, because I'm not a strong believer in money would buy everything. So that's the second aspect of it. And third, I would want to, start with visualizing if it were an art piece, where would it find a place in my house? And what would those memories tell me every time I look at it? So these are some of the things that goes in my head. And I feel so bad because from one house, if you just see the amount of, waste that we send out every day is huge. And I would just do a rough math in my head. Imagine the whole street, the whole world. And plus, I want to inspire a lot of people around me. At least a word of mouth to my friends. They would tell their friends. And this will create, you know, a culture.
You are a beautiful person, and all the empathy and compassion and love that you have for not just human beings, but also the non-living ones that are around, and how beautifully you ingrain those thoughts into reserving it or nurturing it is beautiful. And I want to ask, because this I feel everybody should be knowing, what went into your making or your growing up? How were you as a child, and who were the people, major people who played a very, very important role in you shaping up to be the version that you are right now?
Okay, so my childhood has been very interesting. I was the most naughtiest kid in the school, and nobody would believe me. Say if my class 5th teacher would see me today, she would not believe that I've made it to, you know, to what I am today. I was as notorious as I was, and I was a tough child, and my mom had great difficulty to engage me. And I had this infectious energy, okay, that I wanted to do something all the time. And of course, mother would just get her energy drained, just spend 1 hour with me, and she would find it really difficult to engage me further. So what she did, of course, my mom is a great visionary, and I would owe a lot of whatever I'm today to her. She had seen that creative side in me, while others would always used to, you know, say that, you know, these are least important ones, you know, end of the day, it's scores and marks and grades what defines you, and etc. So my mom did see that talent in me as I was growing up. She knows that, okay, my creative side is very dominant, and you know, my curriculum and all is not so happening. So she put me into this art classes. You know, there was an institution which was an NGO. Initially, she started to avoid me. She's put me there. But later on, as I was picking up things from there, I was creating stuff. She was really proud. And there was no stopping from there.
I want to let everyone know that you're looking amazing today, and you're wearing something that's made by you. Can you show it to everyone and take us through it? Because I definitely know you have a page on Facebook as well, wherein you create some of these pieces of ornament and jewelry. And that's made out of beads, right?
Yes. So these are no regular beads again. These are wooden beads. They're supposed to give some calmness to your body, unlike the plastic ones. And so I bought them specially. I hunt for these big time. I got them done. And I usually make these. I try to avoid a lot of plastic again. Again, doing my best to reduce the plastic usage. So these are made of wooden beads, and these are very special.
That is a beautiful learning. And then maybe make one for me, because I love wearing what you make. You're so incredible. I was mentioning before that you're a jack of many trades, and now is the time we talk about your big connection to food. You love eating, and more than that, since I've been a first-hand witness to it, you love eating. and given your connection to the place you belong to, there are a lot of delicacies that have come out of it. Yes. Some which are close to your heart because of the stories or the people associated with them from your family and outside, or the ones to which you add your flavors. What excites you about food? And I know now might be a good time to ask these, because everybody is at home, and we're all trying new things to keep ourselves engaged. And how is it therapeutic for you? Is it a time pass for you? Is it your preference? What is your connection with food?
I always used to get inspired, because people look forward to, you know, to the cooking, and they all sit down, and there's a lot of respect always given to the person who makes that meal for you, right? And that's the first thing in my head. And I used to feel, oh, there's so much power, you know, with somebody who's making food. And I was like, what better way to get feel empowered? And it's not an idea of you know, women should be in the kitchen or anything of that sort, but you make something to your loved ones, and it does give you a lot of a good feeling. So it all started from there. And another female in my life who inspired me to cook is my grandmother. And one of the dishes that she used to make are kuli panyarams, and that used to be my favorite. During summer holidays we go, and I used to have a lot of my cousins, you know, who would visit, but she knows that that's my favorite. And the way she used to hide some for me, and you know, some, the first batch of it are really special, and she prepares them with a lot of ghee, because I love to eat them with ghee, and she used to reserve them for me. I always used to feel I'm the privileged one in the house, you know, to get those first batch of, you know, kuli panyaram with a lot of ghee. So that's the first of a fond memory of me having kuli panyaram. Till date, what I cook a lot of varieties, and you know, I've been learning you know, a lot of recipes too. I keep experimenting, but one dish that I would die for, and people like you, colleagues, family would die for, is kuli panyaram.
And I also want to let everybody know that we are shooting this on May 31st on a Sunday, and because it's a unique time and everybody's got to be doing a lot of work that they're engaging in, and because tomorrow happens to be a really special day for you, it's your marriage anniversary. So we are going to actually be meeting live tomorrow exclusively for the cooking. Yeah?
Yes.
And we're going to be our decked up avatar like it is right now. We're going to be in our t-shirts and boxers, but we're going to make some amazing kulu. Kulu or kuli? Which one is it?
Panyaram.
Okay. I know mine won't be tasting as good as yours, but then emotions matter. Yes. And let's give it a shot. You look amazing, you're a beautiful person, and thank you for doing this experimental episode with us. We are very, very grateful. Thank you. Talk to you soon. Let's make some healthy bread tomorrow.
Sure. Looking forward for it, Sambhav.
Good morning. How are you doing today?
I'm doing good. I just prepared all the ingredients for the cooking.
Can you take us through the process of how you make it, and then we'll get started?
We would start with first preparing the tadka. So that's the first stage of making the paddus. Yeah. So we would first keep all the ingredients ready for that. And I have here with me the finely chopped onions and curry leaves and chilies here. Okay, so these I have finely chopped. And to just bring some bit of customization and health aspect to it, I have some grated beetroot here.
Right.
And to add more fat to your already fat body, I have
cheese,
grated cheese over here.
Oh, wow.
And for the tadka that is going to go in the pattus, I have some zeera and cumin and mustard seeds.
Right, got it.
These are with very little quantity, just for the tadka.
Set to get started.
Yes, we should.
Like a good student, I'm going to follow you today.
Yes.
So go ahead and then please put the camera in a way that
you
can see what you're doing. Yes, the show-stopping moment is about to begin, and we're ready to be cooking, and I'll need a lot of blessings.
Yes.
I'm going to do it live with you.
Yes, so I'm going to start. Should I start?
Yeah, let's hit the kitchen.
Take a pan like this wide.
Huh.
Okay, heat it up. After 3 tablespoons of oil, we will add zeera and chana dal and mustard seeds, okay?
आप 5 मिनट रुक जाओ, उसको बैटर में डालना मत.
हाँ, नहीं डाल रही हूँ मैं.
आप स्टार्ट में कर लेंगे.
Done, I'll wait for you. Okay, once you start to see the smoke coming out of the pan, you will have to keep the stove in low flame. Because this has to cook 1.5 minutes on each side. So slow cooking is recommended. Otherwise the dough in between would not be cooked. Were you generous enough to add more oil, or you were health conscious?
I am conscious with oil in general, but then I have gone way beyond my limits. So I think that should be fine.
First you start pouring all the batter, like half. Then put the topping. And then put half. Mine are done slightly on one side, so I'm gonna turning it off.
Can't wait to taste these.
I know, it would have been amazing if you would have tasted mine. Kitna difference hota, imagine kariye aap.
Yes, a lot, because once you get addicted to this, there's no stopping. Because these are very soul-soothing, recipes.
Right. Are yours done?
Ready, ma'am. Our dish will be ready any moment.
Let's get ready to serve it. Do you see the sweat? Do you see my sweat, Shalini?
Yes. Yes. And you deserve to eat those golgappas.
Yours are so amazing in color. Here's what mine looks like. Oh God, how do I show it? Interesting. Ready.
And the chutney.
There you go.
Okay.
Yes.
Cheers. I like mine. I've never had this before.
Seriously? How do you like them?
I like the crispness because chana dal ki wajah se, and the beetroot is also adding a very fresh flavor, and it looks like there are a lot of colors, so it looks colorful as well. This is amazing. Talking about experiment, this episode itself is very experimental and could not have been possible without your cooperation. Thank you so much for making me a part of me as well as Zaikana, part of this incredible journey. We are going back with learning something really special and new, and something that's very close to your heart. We would love to say that we have taken a bit of your affection towards this particular item, which is so special to you, and thank you so much.
Thank you.
And thanks Zaikana, and thanks Sambhava and Ishant for making this happen. And my mornings are a bit lazy, especially it's a Monday morning, and thanks for bringing up this whole idea of connecting virtual and then bringing this to life.
Lots of love to you. Stay well. Thank you for this incredible time over 2 days, and specifically this morning schedule where we got up and then we cooked together. Thank you for this beautiful memory.
Thank you for making this bigger. I know I'm gonna get featured in Zaikana, and that's the best thing I feel. So far, only my friends and family would know what I do. Thanks for taking this, online and making it, a lot bigger. Thank you so much.
All right.
I'm scared that this will topple off. Trust me, I'm using every prop possible in my kitchen to just make this happen.
That's great. Yes. Bless you.
No, in corona times you should not say that. You should say get lost.
Man, no. What rubbish. Aur kuch boliye na.
Okay. You will edit it, right?
No.
I will edit it.